Good morning, student. Today we will be going to demonstrate one more experiment for the dynamics of machine learning. This is the technical number 8 or experiment number 8, and the title of the experiment is to plot the characteristic for the forced damped vibration for the given system. Okay. Now let me describe you the experimental apparatus available for this experiment. So here we have to study the transverse vibration of this beam. Okay, so this beam is mounted at one end through the pin joint and on the another end through a spring suspension system. Okay, at the mid of the beam we are having an exciter. The exciter is in the form of the motor, and on the two ends of the motor two pulleys are the mounted. So to produce the exciting force within the system, we will be placing two eccentric mass on the rotors. Okay, so these masses will produce the centrifugal force within the system. What will be the value of the centrifugal force? It will be me omega square. Okay, and the direction of that force will continuously keep on changing as the system will start rotating. Okay, so the magnitude of the force will be equal to me omega square. So as the omega, that is the frequency of the system, will keep on increasing, the magnitude of the force will keep on increasing, and so does the amplitude of the vibration. So this type of the vibrations will be coming into the system. Okay, so there are two steps in this experiment. In the first step, we have to measure the natural frequency of the system. So the one more apparatus which is connected to this beam is the paper recorder. Okay, whatever will be the vibration pattern of the system, that can be captured on the this rotating or the transversing paste with the help of this pencil which is mounted at the one end of the beam. Okay, so in the first step, what we will be doing, we will be measuring the natural frequency of the system without the use of the damper in the system. So when we remove this damper and start running the motor, what we will be getting, or simply as I produce as initial deflection like this, the system will execute transverse vibration. Okay, and when I will start this paper recorder, the paper will start transversing, so the entire vibration pattern will be captured onto this paper, and the number of the oscillations divided by the time will give the natural frequency of the system. But the spring is very stiff over here. Okay, so it will produce the deflection, or you can say the amplitude of the vibration will become very slow. So it is difficult to measure the number of the oscillations or the time period for a particular number of the oscillation. So we will be covering only with the forced vibration of the system. That is the vibration pattern that will be occurring when we are installing this damper onto the system. So what will be happening in the forced vibration? This system, the unbalance into the system, will putting energy into the system, and the same amount of the energy will be dissipated by the damper. So the amplitude of the vibration will remain constant for a time period. So what we will be doing, we will be increasing the speed of the rotor by using this knob. As we increase the speed of the rotor, initially what will be happening over here, the amplitude of the vibration will start increasing. Okay, so we will be noting the frequency, that is the operating frequency, and simultaneously we will be observing the amplitude of the vibration. Then at a particular frequency of the machine, the amplitude of the vibration will become maximum. That will be the natural frequency of the system, and beyond that value of the frequency, the amplitude of the vibration will again decreases. Okay, so that observation we need to take on to this piece of the paper.